Anti-gravity, not in the book. Anti-gravity could be a consequence of relativistic quantum mechanics. There are two waves associated to a relativistic quantum particle. A rigorous presentation of this can be found in the book titled Relativistic and Non-Relativistic Quantum Mechanics, Both at Once, authored by Luis Grave de Peralta and his collaborators, and published by Springer Nature. There are two waves associated to a relativistic quantum particle. Quantum state studies in non-relativistic quantum mechanics give one of the waves. The energy of the particle in this wave is E plus mc2. Exotic quantum state result when a special theory of relativity is incorporated in quantum mechanics. The energy of the particle in this state is E prime minus mc2. Hydrogen-like atoms. For finding the wave associated to the particle in the state with energy, E plus mc2, the particle is the electron, in a hydrogen-like atom, we should solve the Pauli-like Poveda-Poirier-Grave-de-Peralta equation for the electron, shown here. The potential has a minus sign because this is the external attractive Coulomb potential. For this reason, the state with energy E plus mc2 of the electron in the hydrogen-like atom have a spectrum of energy discrete, and this state are spatially localized. A semi-classical description of the same result. The effective relativistic mass of the electron in the state with E plus mc2 is given by the expression shown here. The effective relativistic mass is positive, larger than zero. And this is because the energy of the electron is larger than the Coulomb potential in most of the place where it's signed here by the arrow, the red arrow. Then, semi-classically, we can explain the spatial localization of the state of the electron with energy E plus mc2 in the following way. There is an attraction between the electron and the positive nucleus. This is the force shown here with the green arrow. Because the effective relativistic mass is positive, a centripetal force produce a centripetal acceleration. If the electron is in a quantum state with energy E plus mc2, the Coulomb attraction between the electron and the nucleus produces centripetal acceleration that tends to bring together both particles. Let's talk about the exotic quantum state. Electron quantum state with energy E plus mc2 are spatially localized by external attractive Coulomb potential. However, the exotic electron quantum state with energy E prime minus mc2 are spatially delocalized by the external attractive Coulomb potential. Hydrogen-like atom, exotic state. In this case, if we want to find the wave function corresponding to the exotic state, we should solve the complementary Pauli-like Poveda-Poirier-Grave-de-Peralta equation for the electron, as shown here, where mu prime is the effective relativistic mass of the electron in the exotic state. Mu prime is negative. For this reason, the spectrum of energy of the exotic state of the electron in the hydrogen-like atom is continuous, and the corresponding wave function is spatially delocalized. Hydrogen-like atom, exotic state, a semi-classical description. The effective relativistic mass of electron in the exotic state is negative. Then we can describe the result obtained before semi-classical in the following way. There is a attraction force between the electron and the positive nucleus and the hydrogen-like atoms. The force is shown here with a green arrow. Because the effective relativistic mass in the exotic state are negative, the centripetal force produces a centrifugal acceleration. If the electron is in exotic quantum state with E prime, with energy prime minus epsilon 2, the Coulomb attraction between the electron and the nucleus produces a centrifugal acceleration that tends to separate both particles. This is a very interesting consideration. A spatially homogeneous Dirac quantum vacuum. This is the Dirac quantum vacuum, or a representation of the Dirac quantum vacuum. There is no particle with energy in the state with energy E plus MC2, and all the state with energy, or the exotic state with energy E prime minus MC2 are occupied. The Dirac quantum vacuum concept for the empty space corresponds to all the particle state with energy E plus MC2 being empty, and all the exotic particle state with energy E prime minus MC2 being occupied. Both states are spatially homogeneous plane wave. For this reason, the Dirac quantum vacuum is spatially homogeneous. Any external potential modifies the quantum state. The presence of a nucleus of a hydrogen-like atom modifies the Dirac vacuum. The state with energy E plus MC2 are spatially localized, but the exotic state of the electron in a hydrogen-like atoms are spatially delocalized. Spatially, there is a tendency to be an excess of electron with energy E plus MC2 around the nucleus. In addition, there is a tendency to be a deficit of electrons with energy E prime minus MC2 around the nucleus. Any external potential modifies the quantum state. Spatially, the Dirac quantum vacuum is homogeneous. I show here a representation of this. In the top are the states with kinetic energy positive, empty, homogeneously empty, and in the bottom are the states, the exotic state with energy E prime minus MC2 that are homogeneously occupied. For this reason, the Dirac quantum vacuum is homogeneous spatially. However, the external potential made the Dirac quantum vacuum spatially inhomogeneous. Spatially, there is a tendency to have excess of electrons with energy E plus MC2 around the nucleus. In addition, there is a tendency to have a deficit of electrons in the exotic state with energy E prime minus MC2 around the nucleus. Let us now substitute the Coulomb potential by the gravitational potential. Gravitational attraction between two spin zero particles without electrical charge and with masses M and capital M. Capital M much larger than M. To find the state of the particles with mass M, not capital M, but M, we should solve the Schrödinger-like Poveda-Poirier-Gravel-Peralta equation for the particle with mass M. The equation is shown here. The minus corresponds to the gravitational attraction between the two particles. This potential is external attractive, like the potential, the Coulomb potential that exists in the Schrödinger-like atoms. For this reason, the state of the particle with mass m and energy E plus mc2 will have a spectrum of energy discrete, and the wave function will be spatially localized. Gravitational attraction between two spin zero particles without electrical charge and with masses m and capital M. Capital M much larger than m. A semi-classical description, we have the effective relativistic mass larger than zero, and for this reason, we can describe the spatial localization of the state with energy E plus mc2 in the following way. There is a centripetal force represented here by the green arrow due to the attraction, gravitational attraction between the two masses. The mass m, the effective mass, relativistic mass is positive, then a centripetal force produces centripetal acceleration. Gravity. If the quantum particle with mass m is in the quantum state with energy E plus mc2, the gravitational attraction between the two masses produces centripetal acceleration that then to brings together both particles. This is gravity. Exotic state. Gravitational attraction between two spin zero particles without electrical charge and with masses m and capital M. Capital M much larger than m. To find the exotic state, we should solve the complementary Schrödinger-like Poveda-Poirier-Gravity-Peralta equation for the particle with mass m. The one that is shown here, the minus sign corresponds to the gravitational attraction between the two masses. The effective relative mass is negative, and for this reason, the exotic state of the mass m that is moving around a large mass m, capital M, are half a spectrum of energies continuous, and this state are spatially delocalized. The external attractive gravitational potential produce exotic state spatially delocalized. Exotic state. Gravitational attraction between two spin zero particles without electrical charges and with mass m and capital M. Capital M more larger than m. A semi-classical description. The effective relative mass is negative, and for this reason, we can describe the spatial delocalization of the exotic state of the particle, of the small mass particle, in the following way. There is a centripetal force represented here by the green arrow corresponding to the gravitational attraction between the two particles, but the effective relativistic mass is negative, then a centrifugal force results in a centripetal force results in a centrifugal acceleration. Antigravity, or better, antigravity is the quantum particle with mass m is in exotic quantum state with E prime with energy E prime minus mc2. The gravitational attraction between the particles produces a centrifugal acceleration that tend to separate both particles. Is this antigravity? Any external potential modify the quantum states. The presence of a particle with a large mass modify the Dirac quantum vacuum. The state of a particle with a smaller mass and energy E plus mc2 get spatially localized by the larger mass. However, the exotic state of the smaller mass will be spatially delocalized by the large mass. The case in the top is clearly gravity. The delocalization of the exotic state is anti-gravity. Spatially, there is a tendency to be an excess of particle with mass, with a smaller mass, and energy E plus mc2 around the large mass. In addition, there is a tendency to be a deficit of particle with a smaller mass in the exotic state with energy E prime minus mc2 around the large mass. Any external potential modify the quantum state. A spatially homogeneous Dirac quantum vacuum. The state in the top are the state with energy E plus mc2 are empty. In the bottom are the state with the exotic state with energy E prime minus mc2 are occupied. Both states are spatially homogeneous. This is why the Dirac quantum vacuum is spatially homogeneous. However, the external potential made the Dirac quantum vacuum spatially inhomogeneous. Spatially, there is a tendency to have excess of particles with mass m, smaller masses, with energy E plus mc2 around the large mass. This is gravity. In addition, there is a tendency to have a deficit of particle with a smaller mass and with energy E prime minus mc2, the exotic state, around the large mass. Is this anti-gravity? There is also excess of particles with energy E prime minus mc2 away from the large mass. It is black matter? If the quantum particle with mass m is in the exotic quantum state with energy E prime minus mc2, the gravitational attraction between the particles produces a centrifugal acceleration and tends to separate both particles. This is very interesting. Therefore, there is a tendency to be a deficit of particle with a small mass and energy E prime minus mc2, exotic state, around the large mass. Is this anti-gravity? There is a tendency to be a deficit of particle with a small mass in the exotic state with energy E prime minus mc2 around the large mass. Therefore, there is a tendency to be excess of particle with a small mass in the exotic state with mass E prime minus mc2 far away from the mass m, the large mass. Could this be the origin of the black matter? Now, I want to address an inquietude, a question, a curiosity of one of my best students, Matt. I have to say to Matt, Matt, you may be correct. He had the idea that there is no free lunch in nature. There is no free lunch in life. Nothing is free. He had the idea that there is no free lunch in nature. Now, is there free lunch? Maybe not. When a large mass, capital N, moves through the vacuum with constant velocity, it should repel all the free quantum particles with smaller masses that are close to the large mass, and in the exotic state with energy E prime minus mc2. This is sketched here. When the large mass move around the large mass, there is a deficit of particles with a small mass around the large mass. And this happens when the particle is moving. It is the quantum ether. Therefore, if there is no free launch in nature, then it could be that the large mass cannot move with constant velocity because it has to consume some energy in repelling the small particles that are around the large mass in the exotic state. Interested? Thank you very much.